Water, our most precious natural resource. On December 16, 1974, President Gerald Ford signed the Federal Safe Drinking Water Act, marking the first time a national program of regulations and standards was established to include all public water suppliers in the United States. Walter Mondale, who would later become the Vice President of the United States, was a U.S. Senator when the act was passed.
The 74 Act helped get people's attention, and a lot more progress was made as a result. So we were able to, I would say, fundamentally reform the role of the national government as a protector of the environment and working, of course, with the states and the local governments to get it done. As we used to say, water and air don't respect state boundaries. So the states, Minnesota was probably, again, the best in the country, but many states were not doing a good job. Americans couldn't be sure of safe drinking water. And the 74 Act that we passed was designed to use the power of the federal government to provide leadership and funding to help states do the job.
What I had to decide is, where am I going to stand on these questions? And I laid this principle that with air and water, that is national. And you don't worry about your home area as though you're doing something just for them. You're doing something for a good part of the nation if you work in the air and water part of it, because water travels across state lines. And to leave it to each state, then how horrible it would be if Minnesota, for instance, would not have pure water and it flows in three different areas from the state. And so that's our responsibility as citizens of this nation.
Minnesota was fortunate that it had strong regulations in place well before the Safe Drinking Water Act passed. In 1872, a typhoid fever outbreak linked to impure drinking water created an urgency to establish the State Board of Health, now the Minnesota Department of Health. Throughout the 20th century, Minnesota has expanded its efforts and programs to ensure safe water.
In 1974, when the Safe Drinking Water Act was passed, it really, I think, brought that level of treatment and mandated it for all levels of government and water suppliers in the United States. Whereas before then, it was more than likely identified in the big cities as something that was really required and important. But this brought it out to every public water supply in the United States, which takes that safety aspect not only in the urban areas but out towards all of the areas of the country that are served by public water supplies.
It's important that we continue to talk about prevention. Prevention is the single most effective strategy, the most cost-effective strategy that we have in cleaning up our water resources. If we have to spend money to treat water, either through wastewater treatment or through drinking water treatment plants, that's an unwise use of our money. That's less sustainable than preventing the harm in the first place.
Safe Drinking Water Act ensures that when people take a drink of water in the United States, that they can be assured that water's been tested, the water's safe to drink, and it meets all the requirements of the act.
To be able to go into anybody's home, turn on the tap, get that cold water out there, have a drink of water, and not worry about it. Yeah, and so I love it, because people come here and visit, and then they want a drink of water, and I say, yeah, they grab a glass out of the cupboard, and they open the tap in the kitchen and drink it. I said, they have confidence, not in me, but in this whole community.
Safe drinking water is almost the first requirement of a prosperous community. If you have questions, serious questions about safe water, clean water, people are going to do something about that. And it could be a small town, so it could ruin it. You start with that.
Everyone plays a role in guarding the safety of our water and making sure investments are made to keep it that way. Small but significant actions by individuals can and do result in massive collective gains. While the federal act continues to evolve, Minnesota has made progress in its own ways.
Minnesota has been really forward-looking in terms of environmental issues. And I think the legacy amendment here in Minnesota in 2008, which really set aside some resources to really protect our groundwater and our surface water. And it has been a good investment, and it's an investment for the future while we work today to protect things for our children, our grandchildren, and our great-grandchildren.
Safe and adequate drinking water is something we all rely on. Congress has a responsibility to ensure that America's drinking water is protected and available to everyone. Minnesota, the land of 10,000 lakes, is a leader in providing safe drinking water. Today, over 4 million Minnesotans get their tap water from public water systems. The Minnesota Department of Health, the Metropolitan Council, and other agencies are working together to protect our water sources so all Minnesotans can easily access safe drinking water supplies today and tomorrow.